Hello, John Talley here with Boats.net. Today we're going to spend a little time talking about a boat owner's arch enemy. And what is that? Of course, corrosion. What types are there, and what can we do to maintain it or prevent it from happening on our boats? The first form of corrosion is the simplest, and that's what most people call it, a simple corrosion. As you know, you put something in water, like a piece of steel, and you lay it out in the air, well, guess what? It starts to rust, and that is a form of corrosion. Yamaha has a great lineup of products used to prevent just simple corrosion. Starts with just keeping it clean. Then you want to protect it with a silicone spray. Now, if you're setting it up for long-term storage, well, that's when you spray on the inside. Now, if you're dealing with a fuel injection system, well, they've got that covered as well. Now, the way you want to approach this, each time you take your boat out, when you bring it back home, of course, you want to flush out that engine thoroughly. At that point, spray it down with cleaner and then finish it off by spraying it down with the silicone, which basically encapsulates all the different exposed parts of the engine and keeps them from rusting. Now, if you're going to store it for long term, you either need to use the fogging spray, or if it's a fuel injection model, then you use the fogging oil. The second form of corrosion is probably the most common. It's called galvanic corrosion. In that particular scenario, what you have are two dissimilar metals, either touching or in close proximity, in some type of an electrolyte. And in this case, we're talking about water. What makes it even worse is if it's in salt water. So how do you combat that when you've got a stainless steel output shaft connected to a bronze propeller? Well, you give it something a little bit softer to go after instead of that bronze propeller, which actually makes your boat move. And those are called sacrificial anodes. They are physically connected to the boat in various areas. They can be on the outdrive, they can actually be on the engine itself. Anything that comes into contact with water, you're typically going to find an anode. Now, it's going to be very important for you to know the location of each one of the anodes on your particular motor, because just because you see the ones down at the bottom, there may be more that are hidden under that engine cover. It's important to make sure that they're all functioning. Otherwise, well, it's going to attack the engine instead, and we don't want that to happen. Now, as you can tell by this lower unit, they had it tilted up, and there's a nice even water line where this part was down in the water. The anode was up here in the air. So what did it go after? It went after the lower part of that drive. Now, outside of making sure that your anodes are in good shape, you also want to make sure that your boat is properly bonded together. When I say bonded, I'm talking about your different electrical and or mechanical aspects of the boat. They need a common thread to keep them at the same potential difference. Otherwise, you can run into that same galvanetic type scenario where you've got this one at a higher potential than this one, and then of course it's going to eat it alive. One of the best systems out there is actually the Mercathode system by Mercury / Mercruiser. And what it is a solid state system that is actually operating off of your boat's 12 volt battery, and it is integrated into the engine / outdrive of the boat. And what it does, it actually produces a reverse current that shields off the galvanetic type current that's trying to attack the metals of the engine. It's a pretty neat system, but you need to get it tested annually, because there's no way for you to look at it and go, hey, that's working. If just one wire is broken or one strap is disconnected, the Mercathode system will not work. And I know firsthand just how destructive that can be. Now, as you can see from these pictures, this was not an easy process. It had to go through a cleaning, priming, and then painting procedure that was multi-layered. Took quite a bit of time. Unfortunately, I could not save the gimbal housing, and it had to be replaced. It was just too far gone for me to straighten it out. The last type of corrosion I want to discuss is actually what they call stray current, and that is caused when there's an electrical issue either at the dock or potentially on your own boat. The most destructive of those is going to be on the DC side, if anything. Picture, if you will, you've got your wiring going through your bilge and it's making a connection to the bilge pump. If you just used a regular connector, that's laying in water where it's got a pathway to go from your bilge all the way out through your engine, because it's looking for a ground, which is the water that your boat is sitting in. The best way to prevent that type of scenario is to make sure that all your connections are actually watertight. Do every single connection on your boat as if it's going to be placed underwater. That is my rule of thumb. Now, there are instances where your boat is doing exactly what it's supposed to, but the dock is not. And you could be getting stray current back to your drive through the actual shore power system. Now, to combat this, what I would recommend you install on your boat is what they call a galvanic isolator. It actually is in line on your AC side on the ground, which is actually incoming from the shore power. That effectively will block any type of current that's trying to travel through the dock out to your boat and then into the water. Cheap insurance, and believe me, if you don't have it in place, it can eat that outdrive alive just like that. So where does that leave us on the entire global topic of corrosion? Well, prevention is worth a pound of cure, I guarantee you. At least do the simplest thing. Make sure it's clean, make sure it's sprayed down to keep your simple corrosion at a minimum at best. Each time you run your boat, before or after, check all your anodes. Just put your eyes on. Take a look at your drive. Make sure you're not starting to get any type of bubbling up of the paint anywhere. If you catch it really early, you can correct it much cheaper than if it eats the drive alive. Well, listen, if you need any parts, maintenance pieces, sprays, lubricant for your boat, why don't you come see us at boats.net and we can get you taken care of. Have any questions or comments, or if there's another topic that you'd like me to cover, why don't you leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them and or do a video about it. Listen, we just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at boats.net, and we will see you in the next video. Have a great day.